Recently, Venerable Vibhu Syaro passed away and was the Arhant. His teaching was that he will just teach anapan, nothing else. He would say, just observe the breath coming in, going out. Just observe this and keep on observing it till you reach the final goal. Observing the breath, you start getting sensation there. That is essential. The stage must come when you feel sensation here. And then this sensation will automatically spread. Let it spread in the whole body. And then the gross sensation passes away, the subtle sensation. You have to reach the stage which is bhanga, where you get sensation in the tiniest particle of your body. And like that, the whole path. The path remains the same, the technique remains the same. But the emphasis is given only on anapana, anapana. Like this. There are different ways. Buddha also found out this person is suitable for that. This person is suitable for that. These 10 sannyas are different techniques in one way to start the work, but after reaching a certain stage of bhanga, it becomes the same, makes no difference. So he used to give a particular technique to a particular person according to the background of this person. Now the traditions are where a certain technique is maintained in the past till now, and that technique works with people who are suitable for that. If it doesn't work, then they can take some other technique. But whatever the technique may be, it is just the beginning point. Ultimately, you have to reach the stage of bhanga, and from bhanga, all those things come. We reach the stage of nibbana. Now, this anapan sati technique is that you keep on giving importance to breath up to the end, up to the nibbanic stage. The mind becomes calm, the mind becomes quiet, and how the mind gets rid of the sankharas, and how you reach the stage where you take the dip in the nibbanic stage, the nirodha stage. As you breathe out, you're going in the nibbodha stage, and then you breathe in and you are coming out, and the period of nirodha, one cannot say, it depends. It may be a few moments, it may be a few seconds, it may be a few minutes, it may be a few days. The longest period that we have found with experience in Burma, and also what we find in the scriptures, are 7 days. We have not found people going in nirodha state more than 7 days. But 7 days, a big time by itself. Nirodha, you go in nirodha, you come out of nirodha, you go in nibbanic stage, you come out of nibbanic stage. And then once by the arhant, having reached of the nirodha of arhant, then you come out, then you find that you can't make now any more impurity. You can't generate any sankhara of any type, which will take you to any new world, which will give you a new birth. And that means you have come out of it now. You have come out of all the sankharas, of all such bhav sankharas, which will give you a new birth. So all that process comes as you proceed further with this anapan sati, anapan sati.